this is a honey. Play 'em smart and take the money on Card Sharks. And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry.
Hi, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you for joining us. Thank you. Ah, you're very kind. That's nice. You have made my day. Thank you. And a special vote of thanks to Dora Spiro of Cleveland, Ohio, who sent in that opening poem. Pretty good, Dora. Certainly better than Gene's. We're about to start the second game on our best 2 out of 3 match, so that's the cue to open the board and get to the cards. Janice and Ann, if you will, start loading in the cards. And while they do that, we'll meet our players on Card Sharks. Patricia Ortiz. Hi, Patricia. Nice to see you again. Would
nice
you remind
to be
us
here.
About yourself?
I'm a recent graduate from USC studying speech pathology. I'll be going to graduate school in the fall, and I like all kinds of water sports.
What does a speech pathologist do?
That would be helping anyone who has a speech problem. If they don't like the sound of their voice, they can change it, or if they have a really physiological type problem, they can get that changed.
That sounds
too.
Interesting. Good.
Yes.
Nice to have you back. You've won $1,300, so that's not too bad for a champion.
No.
And our challenger, Regina Gurley.
Hi,
Regina. Nice to see you again.
Good. Thank you.
Would you tell us about yourself again?
Yes. I am a native Californian. I work for a major carrier. At the moment, I lived in Los Angeles last week. I've just moved to Washington, D.C. this week, and I don't know where all my things are, but they're someplace.
Oh, everything is lost
in
transit?
It's someplace between here and D.C.
And you work for an airline?
Yes, I do. Well, listen. No. They're trucking my things. Trucking. Airlines.
I was just thinking there was some justice in the world somewhere, Regina.
No, airlines are great.
I hope everything gets found.
Thank you.
Good luck to both of you. Each player has her own deck of 52 playing cards shuffled and cut before we go in the air. The upper cards, the red cards, will be played by the champion, Patricia. The lower cards, the blue cards, will be played by the challenger, Regina. Before you can begin to call high-low in the cards, you must first win a high-low toss-up question, and they're based on a poll of 100 people. Starting with a question to you, Patricia. Remember, we play the best 2 out of 3, and game one went to the champion. So, Regina, right away, you need this game. Patricia, we asked 100 women. If you had your choice, would you rather have Farrah Fawcett's body or her income? How many women would rather have Farrah Fawcett's body?
Well, her body may be appealing to most men, but I don't think to most women. And they would really rather have her income because then they could get whatever they want anyway. So I will say that 65.
65 would rather have her body.
Now, her income.
No. Uh-oh. The question is, how many women would rather have Farrah Fawcett's body?
Body? Oh, 35.
35. Boy, your math is terrific, Patricia.
Thank you.
Regina, higher or lower than 35?
Lower. It has to be lower because you can get a body, but no, lower.
But money's harder to come
by.
The actual number of women who would prefer having Farrah Fawcett's body to having her income is 6. Very much lower, Regina. Yeah. I don't understand that at all because I'd rather have her body myself. Regina, your base card is a 10.
A 10.
You won the question.
Okay.
You have the right to change it if you'd like.
I think I'm gonna change it.
All right,
it's
you
a high
must
card,
play
and
this
I'm gonna
one.
Change it.
Next card is a 9.
Ooh, boo hiss.
Not
all
a good
right,
shape.
That's all right. It's lower. Next card is lower.
Boo definitely. Hiss.
Boo hiss. That's better than saying other things.
Lower than a 9,
lower,
she
lower,
says.
Lower.
No, it's a king. It's not lower. That means you lose that card and you give Patricia a chance to play off. A 3.
Great. The next card's higher.
Higher than a 3. It is an 8.
I'll freeze.
You'll freeze. We move the freeze bar over. Can't take those cards away from you. Anne will fill in the spaces. And question 2 goes to you, Regina.
Okay.
We asked 100 people, if a prostitute is arrested, should her male customer be arrested also? How many people said her male customer should be arrested?
Should be arrested. I think they should be arrested, but I would have to say that it would be rather high. Most people would say maybe about 60,
60 out of 100 say
the
man
should
also be arrested.
Yes, should be.
What do you think, Patricia?
Okay, these are just 100 people, no particular sex.
100 people at random.
I think it would be a little bit higher than that still.
You think even more?
Yeah, people want justice in this world, so.
The actual number of people who said that if a prostitute is arrested, her male customers should be arrested also is 74. It's higher, Patricia. Yeah.
Okay, what a
We're looking at an eight, but you can change it.
Change it, please.
And here's the next card off the top of your deck of four. Good change.
Great. Okay, the next card's higher.
Higher than a four? It is a five.
I'm going to go and say the next card's higher still.
Higher than a five, risking that one and this one. Yes, it's a queen.
We're going to go all the way and say the next card's lower.
If this is lower, you've won two in a row in the championship for the win. Yes, it's a nine. She did it again. Congratulations, Patricia.
Thank you.
Regina.
Well, what can I say?
It was a delight. Thank you for joining us. I hope you find all your stuff.
I do, too.
I'm sure you will.
Thank you.
Thanks for being here. Come on down, Patricia. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Patricia Ortez will play the money cards where she can win thousands of dollars right after we take time out for this message. That's nice. The audience is rooting you on here, Patricia. Then let's not keep them or you waiting. Let's open the board and get to the money cards. Come on, Patricia. All right, at $100 a game, now you've won $200. Yours to keep. We're going to give you a brand new deck of cards, all shuffled and cut, and new money to play with. This time you're going to bet that money. You'll start on the bottom line with $200 and three cards. When you move to the second level, we add another $200 of betting money and we give you three more cards. Your decision how you bet them, $50 minimum bets, till you get to that top card, the big bet. There you must bet at least half your money. Good luck. It can add up. Here's $200. And as in the game, a choice of two base cards, Patricia. You'll start with a biggie. That's the way to start.
Okay.
$200
in a day. The next card is low.
The whole thing.
$200.
Lower than an ace. Oh, yeah. It's still a good card. A king.
$400. It's lower.
Again, the whole thing.
The whole thing.
$400. Lower than a king. A jack.
Right. I'm going to go the whole thing that it's lower still.
Again. $800. Lower than a jack. Yes. It's an eight. Patricia, you have cleared the board on the bottom level. $1,600. The eight moves up. We add the other $200 of betting money. Patricia, you're at top dollar right now. You've got $1,800, but you're looking at your first really tough card. What's your decision?
I'm going to bet $100. The next card is lower.
All right, let's see if we can improve it for $100. $100 lower than an eight. No, it's a jack. Well, you might have had a premonition, but you got a better card out of it and $1,700.
Okay, I'll bet $700 that the next card is lower.
Yeah. Let's see a deuce now. $700 lower than a jack. And it is very much lower. $2,400 and a five, Patricia.
Card is higher.
A big bet. $1,400 higher than a five. No, it's a two. Oh, what a time, but you got a great card
great
to move
card.
Up for the big
yeah.
bet with. You still got $1,000. You must bet at least $500.
Okay, I'm going to bet the whole thing that it's higher.
All right, come on. Nothing or $2,000 if this is higher than a two. No. The card started so great for you.
I know, it's really.
Oh, that's amazing. Terrible. That's you bet it right too. Oh, come on down here, Patricia. That is off. I thought you were gonna break the bank there for a moment. Doggone it. But you're still the champion, and you'll meet a new challenger. I maybe she'll get a chance to do it again right after we take time out for this. Two brand new decks of cards, if you will, and start loading them in over there, and we'll meet our next challenger on Card Sharks. Jim Work. Hi, Jim.
Hello, Jim.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Why don't you tell us about yourself?
All right. My name is Jim Work, and it's spelled W-O-R-K, and I'm from Birmingham, Alabama. And this is this is the first time I've been out to the coast. I've been out here about 2 weeks, and I represent a company that manufactures plant containers or flower pots. So while I'm here, I'm going to be the head pot pusher out here.
Well, you'll be right at home here then, Jim. Good luck in the match. You'll play the blue cards, the lower cards, and Patricia plays the upper cards, the red cards. Patricia, we'll start with a question to you. We asked 100 women, if there were a pill that made you 10 years younger, but it also made you bow-legged. Would you take it? How many women said, yeah, they'd take that pill?
Bow-legged is pretty bad, even if you are 10 years younger. I'd say very few. 15 people.
15 people. What do you think, Jim? Higher or lower than 15?
Well, there's one thing about it. Well, these women, they can wear long dresses, they can wear pants and all kind of things now. True. But it's hard to get 10 years younger. I'm going to say it's higher.
You say higher. The actual number of women who would take a pill that made them 10 years younger but bow-legged is 7. It's not higher, Patricia. Wow. Oh, you've heard that expression, vanity, thy name is woman. My goodness. Patricia, your base card. A king.
Great. Okay, terrific. I'll keep it, and I'll say the next card is lower.
Lower than a king? It's a queen,
okay.
Yes.
Okay, I'll continue and say the next card's lower.
Risking that card and this one lower than a queen, and it is just a 6.
I'm going to freeze right there.
And she'll freeze. Patricia needs just 2 cards, and of course that keeps Jim away from his cards if you don't make a mistake. Jim, we asked 100 third grade kids in Billings, Montana. Is a person very... They're all here. I see it. Is a person who's 25 very old? How many third graders thought a person who was 25 is very old?
Well, I guarantee that I know that they think anybody over 15 is old. So I'm going to say they're 69.
69. Higher or lower, Patricia?
Well, there's a difference between old and very old. So I think it'll be just a little bit lower.
You say lower.
Yeah.
Was that an editorial comment there, friend? The actual number of third graders in Billings, Montana, who thought a person who was 25 is very old is 7. Very much lower, Patricia.
Okay, great.
They were a little smarter there than you thought, those third graders.
Yeah, okay, I'm going to change that card,
now
please.
You can change the 6, and she does, to a 5.
Okay,
better card.
A little bit better. I'll say the next card's higher.
Higher than a 5? No, it's a 4. And that's the first break for Jim, who gets a look at his card. A 9. You didn't win the question, so you can't change it, Jim. You got to play it.
All right, I'm going to take that 9 and go lower with it.
Lower than a 9?
Come on, baby.
Yes, it's a 6.
All right. I'm going to take the 6, and I'm going to try it, and I'm going higher with the 6.
Higher than a 6?
Come on, baby.
No, it's a 3. And you couldn't advance. We'll fill in the spaces and go to you, Patricia, with this question. We asked 100 women in Nashville, Tennessee. Some friends of yours, Jim.
Neighbors.
If you got stuck between floors in an elevator with just one other person, 100 women in Nashville, would you rather that person be Robert Redford or an elevator repairman?
Oh, no question.
How many women said they'd rather be stuck with Robert Redford?
Oh, that is a simple question. Someone eventually will come around and fix the elevator, but until then you can have a really good time. So I would say 90.
90. Would rather have Redford than the elevator repairman, Jim.
Oh, you know what? I agree with her. Somebody can come fix an elevator, but for a woman, how often you get to be with Robert Redford? I'm going to say higher.
Higher than that. The actual number of women who would rather be stuck in an elevator with Robert Redford than an elevator repairman is 74. Not higher, Patricia. There are a few pragmatists left in the world. Patricia, you're looking at a 5.
I'll keep the 5 and say the next one is higher.
Higher than a 5? No, it's a 3. And again, she could not advance. And that's the advantage of that freeze bar. We cannot take you back any further than that. Jim, you've got a 9. What's this?
I'm going to try him lower again.
Lower than a 9.
Come
yes,
on, baby.
A 2.
All right. That's my card. All right. Let's take him higher.
Higher than a 2?
Come on.
It's a 5.
All right. Okay. I'm going to try him one more time higher.
Higher than a
5?
No, it's a 2. And you lose all 3 cards back to the base card. And we go to the 4th and final question. It is sudden death. Someone has to win with this play of the cards. Jim, we asked 100 pediatricians across the country. Do you think that children today are more spoiled than when you were a child? How many children's doctors thought children today are more spoiled?
Well, with the Dr. Spock and everybody else that's come along, I'll say that there were 71.
71. Children's doctors say they're more spoiled today. Patricia?
I think it's a little bit lower because parents are becoming more conscious on how to raise their children properly. So I will say the number is lower.
You say lower?
Yes.
This will decide that all-important control. The actual number of pediatricians who thought children today are more spoiled is 60. It's lower, Patricia. Now, Patricia, listen carefully. It is sudden death. You have a 5. You have the right to change it and try to turn these 2 cards over. But if you made a mistake, Jim wins the game. However, you can force Jim to play off the 9, which he cannot change, and he would have to turn over all 4 cards, or it's your game. Your decision, Patricia. Play it or pass it?
Pass, definitely.
Pass it.
Thank you, dear.
All right, Jim, you got it. If you can turn them all over, you've won the first game of the match. One mistake, and it belongs to Patricia. Call this.
All right. All right, here we go again. We're going lower.
Lower than a 9. No, right away, it's not lower. Patricia wins game number 1 and $100. And to clear the board, we'll start game number 2 of this match right after this. So the champion is game number 1 and $100. And Jim, the pressure's on now. Gotta come true for the South, right?
There you go. The South
will
rise
again. Same 2 decks of cards. And a load in the cards now. And if you can remember what cards are played, that often helps. Patricia, the question to you. Speaking of the South, we sent our man on the street to President Carter's hometown of Plains, Georgia, where we asked 100 people, if President Carter saw you, would he know you by name? Now, just to let you know, the population of Plains is under 400 people. How many people in Plains said President Carter would know them by name?
I would think a lot would, even if it were not true. So I'll say 80.
What, you say a lot they, would, even if it were not true?
Yeah.
They think he knew them, right?
They think he would know him.
I see. Uh-huh. Jim, higher or lower?
Well, I tell you what, I think he knows everybody. So I think it's going to be higher, particularly in Plains. If he doesn't know everybody in Plains, you know, that somebody's feelings are hurt.
Okay. The actual number of people in Plains, Georgia, who said President Carter knows them by name is 69, not higher, Patricia. But still a very high number. Patricia, your base card, an ace.
Oh, terrific. I'll keep it and say the next card's lower.
Lower than an ace. No! Ooh, I think that happened to you with 2 deuces a little while ago, Patricia. Jim, your base card, a 9.
Beautiful. That's my favorite card. I'm going to take him down lower.
Lower. Very gently lower, he says. No, it's another ace. Yes, that's right. Well, we said there are 2 decks up there. You've got to save cards. Jim, we pulled 100 Playboy bunnies and asked them, have you ever gone topless on a public beach? How many bunnies said they had?
On a public beach.
On a public beach, yes.
I would say a Playboy bunny, you know, they... On a public beach, they get enough exposure where they are. So I would say there'd be 25 that went public.
Went public. Yes.
Went public on the top of this beach.
Jim says 25 of them went public. Patricia, higher or lower?
I think it would be lower. If they were to go topless, it would be in the magazine. So I would say it's lower than 25.
The actual number of Playboy bunnies who said they'd gone topless on a public beach is 21. It's lower, Patricia. Well, what do you want to do with that ace, Patricia?
Okay, it has to be lower this.
It has to be lower.
Yes.
And it is. Right. It's a 6.
I'm going to go one more time and say it's higher.
Risking that card in this one higher than a 6? No, it's a 3. Could not advance. A break for Jim.
All
you're
right.
Still looking at that fine 9, Jim.
I'm gonna get him yet. I'm going lower.
Lower than a 9? No! And a jack. Couldn't advance. Wow! Question 3, and it goes to... It goes to the you at home, where I ask you the question, would you watch this commercial? I got out of that somehow, didn't I? So our champion leads 1-0. Jim Work is batting 100. You didn't get any of them right, right?
I didn't answer the question right yet.
Maybe he'll make a comeback next time on Guard Sharks.
One of our polling groups will receive a Kelvinator no-frost refrigerator with generous 3.4 cubic foot freezer, adjustable shelves, dual crispers, turn-the-wall insulation, and ice maker capability furnished by Kelvinator. And some of our contestants will receive Blu-ray fashionable sunglasses that win admiring stares while protecting from annoying glare, 86 eye-catching styles. See what you're missing with Blu-ray polarized sunglasses. And town and country tableware by Washington Forge, beautiful Fleetwood handles, and Mirror Bright stainless steel dishwasher safe from Washington Forge. And Sealamil, your cooking airtight bags go from freezer to hot water, no mess, no bother. Daisy Sealamil simplifies your life. And Miro's electric What a Pizzeria, professional style pizza from frozen mix or scratch. Save 70% energy over range ovens. What a Pizzeria from Miro. Speaking for Card Sharks, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.